This video is brought to you by Patient Guard, experts in medical device regulatory affairs and quality assurance. Before we start, please subscribe to our channel and keep informed of our new content. Clause 7.3 of the ISO 13485 standard outlines the requirements for design and development in a medical device quality management system. The purpose of this clause is to ensure that the medical devices are designed and developed in a manner that ensures safety and effectiveness. The first requirement of Clause 7.3 is that the organisation must establish, document, and maintain procedures for design and development. These procedures must ensure that design and development activities are planned, controlled, and monitored, and that they are conducted in accordance with regulatory requirements. The organisation must also establish a design and development process that includes the following activities. Planning. This activity includes the identification of customer and regulatory requirements, the establishment of design and development objectives, and the development of a project plan. Input. This activity includes the identification and management of design inputs, such as customer requirements, regulatory requirements, and product specifications. Output. This activity includes the development of design outputs, such as product specifications, design documents, and manufacturing instructions. Review. This activity includes the review and approval of design outputs to ensure that they meet the design inputs and regulatory requirements. Verification. This activity includes the testing and evaluation of design outputs to ensure that they meet the design inputs and regulatory requirements. Validation. This activity includes the testing and evaluation of the final product to ensure that it meets the customer and regulatory requirements. Transfer. This activity includes the transfer of the design to manufacturing, including the establishment of manufacturing instructions and the training of manufacturing personnel. Changes. This activity includes the management of changes to the design and development process, including the review and approval of changes and the communication of changes to relevant personnel. The organisation must also establish procedures for the management of design and development records, including the maintenance of design and development files and the retention of design and development records. Another important requirement of Clause 7.3 is the establishment of a design and development team. The organisation must ensure that the team have the necessary knowledge, skills and experience to conduct the design and development activities, and that it includes representatives from all relevant disciplines, such as engineering, quality assurance, and regulatory affairs. The standard also requires that the organisation establish procedures for the control of design and development changes. This includes the identification, evaluation, and control of changes to the design and development process, and communication of the changes to relevant personnel. One of the key aspects of Clause 7.3 is risk management. The organisation must establish procedures for the identification, evaluation, and control of risk associated with the design and development process. This includes the development of a risk management plan, the identification of hazards and potential harms associated with the product, the assessment of probability and severity of harms, and the development of risk control measures to mitigate risks. Another important aspect of Clause 7.3 is the use of design and development inputs and outputs as part of the overall product realization process. The organization must ensure that the design and development outputs are properly transferred to the manufacturing process, and the design and development inputs are properly identified and controlled throughout the product realization process. Finally, The organization must establish procedures for the validation of the design and development process. This includes the development of validation plans and the conduct of validation activities to ensure that the design and development process is capable of producing products that meet customer and regulatory requirements. If you liked this video, then please click like and hit the subscribe button to keep up to date with the latest videos from PatientGuard, making regulation easy.